I've got the codes.
All right, then let's get right to it. Please insert stolen security codes now. Strike a key when ready. And it's done. Like they say, easy money.
That's it?
With the proper equipment, it only takes a moment. We can fight Skynet with our own weapons. I believe that goes for that infiltrator as well. The first prototype just came out a couple of days ago. Imagine what happens if they become mass-produced. We need to hurry before that happens.
That infiltrator has been after us for more than just a couple of days.
What do you mean?
It's been following me for months.
But that simply can't be. That prototype has been out for mere days.
It's the same model that destroyed Pacific Division.
But I'm connected to Skynet's mainframe and I can see their plans. I'm telling you that what you're saying is not possible. Unless... Oh my God. They will do it. They will finish the TDE.
Finish what?
TDE, time displacement equipment. For all intents and purposes, it's a time machine.
A time machine?
Yes, a time machine. You go in, you pick a date, you press a button, and just like that, you'll be watching your younger self learning to tie your shoelaces. You know, time travel. Skynet's been working on TDE for a while now. I've been monitoring its progress, but it's still not ready yet.
So how could they send anyone back if it's not ready?
They didn't, but they will. Don't you see? In one alternative future, they finished TDE and sent a Terminator back to our times. That has to be the one you saw. You couldn't have seen it otherwise. It didn't exist yet. That would explain why they suddenly started to learn at such a geometric rate. This is big. This is really big.
So, if it's done, then what the fuck can we do now?
We can still fight for this future. Our future. You could stop Skynet before they finish building time displacement equipment and send any more Terminators back. I'm forwarding everything I've learned to Connor. He needs to know. And you go report back to Baron.
Speaking of Baron... What happened between you and Baron?
Years ago, Connor gave an order to infect Skynet with a virus. To do it, we had to reboot a T-800 model I was trying to reprogram. I warned them that I wasn't done and that the Terminator was fully functional, but they didn't listen. So, as expected, it went online and sent our coordinates to Skynet. But not only that, it attacked and killed Perry. Baron took it personally because they were an item. She's been holding a grudge ever since.
She sent me to kill you.
Oh.
I'm not going to do it. But if she finds out that I didn't, she'll send someone who will.
Thank you for telling me. If what you're saying is true, I don't have much time. As soon as I'm done packing, I'll be on my way. Oh, do you have that CPU I asked for?
No, I couldn't get it.
I have little faith in Alvin, but let's hope he'll put that chip to good use. Our lives might depend on it. I've already sent all the blueprints and access codes to Connor. Grab that plasma behind you, and go see Baron.
I've got the codes.
All right, then let's get right to it. Please insert stolen security codes now. Strike a key when ready. And it's done. Like they say, easy money.
That's it?
With the proper equipment, it only takes a moment. We can fight Skynet with our own weapons. I believe that goes for that infiltrator as well. The first prototype just came out a couple of days ago. Imagine what happens if they become mass-produced. We need to hurry before that happens.
That infiltrator has been after us for more than just a couple of days.
What do you mean?
It's been following me for months.
But that simply can't be. That prototype has been out for mere days.
It's the same model that destroyed Pacific Division.
But I'm connected to Skynet's mainframe and I can see their plans. I'm telling you that what you're saying is not possible. Unless... Oh my God. They will do it. They will finish the TDE.
Finish what?
TDE, time displacement equipment. For all intents and purposes, it's a time machine.
A time machine?
Yes, a time machine. You go in, you pick a date, you press a button, and just like that, you'll be watching your younger self learning to tie your shoelaces. You know, time travel. Skynet's been working on TDE for a while now. I've been monitoring its progress, but it's still not ready yet.
So how could they send anyone back if it's not ready?
They didn't, but they will. Don't you see? In one alternative future, they finished TDE and sent a Terminator back to our times. That has to be the one you saw. You couldn't have seen it otherwise. It didn't exist yet. That would explain why they suddenly started to learn at such a geometric rate. This is big. This is really big.
So, if it's done, then what the fuck can we do now?
We can still fight for this future. Our future. You could stop Skynet before they finish building time displacement equipment and send any more Terminators back. I'm forwarding everything I've learned to Connor. He needs to know. And you go report back to Baron.
Speaking of Baron...
But... What are you doing?
Did Commander Baron order you to do this?
Please... Please think about it. I'm the only one that can stop Skynet. You need me!
Commander.
I'm here. Is the thing with Mac taken care of?
It is. But I have some news for you.
Go ahead.
Thank you.
Here's the man of the hour.
Sergeant, are you taking a tour with us?
Repeat it back to me.
Know your target. I think these ones have a 5-second fuse.
Do you need anything?
Can I see your hardware?
Need anything?
Can I see your hardware?
This is it, huh? No more turning back. Whatever happens, you know what? It's probably bad luck to say goodbye, right?
Rivers, just when you thought shit couldn't get any more crazy, this happens.
So what now?
With the infiltrators coming out and news of a fucking time machine, Connor wants to finish this war fast.
Are we prepared?
Nowhere near. That's why an all-out attack is our only option. Alvin managed to locate Skynet's central core through the hijacked satellite. It turns out it's right under our nose. It's in the basement of the old Griffith Observatory.
So we're moving out.
You are. Connor wants me to stay here to coordinate the attack. And his North Division is heading to stop Skynet from sending anything through the time displacement equipment.
So this is it.
It does seem that way. You better get all your things sorted. Take your time. You're leaving in a couple of hours. Dismissed.
They gave me a rifle? I don't even know how to use one. They said it's hot, but it doesn't seem hot to me at all.
Jacob, you're moving out?
I am. What about you?
I'm part of a scavenging team now, but Commander Baron gave us an order to get back to the shelter. If you see Jennifer, can you tell her that?
Okay. Where is she?
Last time I saw her, she was upstairs.
nice view.
How did you find me?
Patrick told me you might be somewhere around here.
It's my thinking spot. Is he worried?
No, he seems happy. How did he do on your first scavenging hunt together?
Well, at first he was excited just to be outside. A little too excited. Some drones spotted him. But I did it. I managed to protect him. Nothing happened. And from that point on, he understood how dangerous a scavenger's life can be.
See, you'll make a great scavenging team.
Yeah, I'm starting to see it that way. And because of that, I was thinking...
About leaving?
I don't have any secrets from you, do I? Yeah, about leaving. With Patrick.
You know, I think you should stay. This is not a time to think about personal problems. There's a war to fight.
Spoken like a true soldier. But you know what? You're right. It's probably incredibly selfish of me to even consider leaving. Especially now this war is about to end. I'll stay. Support the cause. Maybe even start faking enthusiasm while talking to Baron. You're always looking out for me. Thank you for that. I know you're moving out soon, but there's something I want to say. Regardless of what happens later, I hope that we'll find each other. Thank you for always being there for me. I'm lucky to have someone like you.
And I'm lucky to have you.
I hoped you'd say that. You know what? I'll stay here just a little while longer. Tell Patrick not to worry. I'll be back soon.
I'll do that.
You ready to move out?
I am.
All right. Let's do this. 30 years ago, the machines decided to wipe out all of humanity because they feared that we were a threat to their existence. Today, we make their fear come true. Sergeant Rivers, you were requested by John Connor to lead the Alpha Team. You will be responsible for carrying out the attack on the location of Skynet's central core. We will create a diversion to lure out any HK aerials patrolling the area. That should give you some time to breathe. Taking out Skynet's ground forces, that's on you. Remember, the goal is to destroy Skynet's central core, at whatever cost. Good luck out there. Dismissed.
This is us. Let's move out. We're 2 minutes out from the observatory. As soon as we get past that barrier, expect SKYNET to show up. Stay focused. Silverfish, 12 o'clock.
Neutralized.
Let's keep moving. Pushing forward!
Metals!
Keep pushing forward!
Metals! Good shooting!
Fire!
Hang in there. Watch the flame! More of them! More incoming! Suppressing fire!
Another infiltrator?
No, he's with us. Took you a while. How did you know we were coming? I thought you'd know by now. I know more than you think. Better prepare yourself.
On that HK! They're coming from the west gate! Focus on that HK! They're coming from the west gate!
This is it!
Follow me. Downstairs.
How do you know?
I've been here before. I've seen it. Watch out! This is it. Skynet's finished. Supposed to be right here. They knew we were coming. They moved it. It's a trap. A fucking trap.
We have to move. Those missiles are headed this way.
Wait! If we triggered the attack, it means that this place is still connected to Skynet's mainframe. If we trace where the signal's coming from, we'll know the central core's actual location.
How could they know we were coming?
Skynet was about to lose the war. They sent an infiltrator back in time. We must have warned them about this attack.
How do you know all this?
Because I went back after that infiltrator. Yes! I've got the coordinates. Let's go! Makes sense to you soon, but right now we need to go! Commander, Central Core, it's not here. It was an ambush. Commander! You can't die here. Get up! Baron, I've got the coordinates. Can you hear me? Where the hell are you? Ryan. Commander!
Rivers, you're alive!
What happened here?
An infiltrator got in. Brought lots of friends with him. We didn't stand a chance. Since they didn't go offline, I assume we did not destroy Skynet's central core either?
No. No, we didn't. It was an ambush. They moved it before we got there.
So this is it? We lost? We lost this goddamn war?
Not yet.
What do you mean?
I got the central core's real coordinates.
You have? I've got to learn not to doubt you anymore, Rivers.
We need to call Connor. He may still be able to stop Skynet.
Forget it. I couldn't get him on the radio for hours. You need to find him. You need to give him those coordinates.
First, let's get you out of here.
No. You don't have time for this. You have to leave me here.
I can't.
You're not gonna disobey my final order, are you? Before you leave, I've got a confession to make. There's a reason I wasn't so keen on you from the beginning. Remember that list of people Skynet marked for termination? I lied. I told you that you were number three. The truth is, you're number two, just behind Connor. You took my spot, and for the life of me, I couldn't understand why. But now I know. They're coming. You need to leave, now. Use a vent in the command room to sneak past them, and then find Connor and give him those coordinates. Don't worry about me. If they come here, I'll just reason with them. I still have a couple magazines full of arguments. Now go! Good luck, Jacob.
The stranger died in that ambush trying to protect me. He came from the future to save my life, and I don't even know his identity. But thanks to his sacrifice, I managed to escape with the Central Core's true location. When I got back to the shelter, I realized that getting that information cost the life of many others as well. I headed out to find John Connor and his North Division to take part in the last all-out attack. Anyone receiving me? This is Sergeant J. Jacob Rivers, DN46890. Anyone out there? If anyone's hearing this, please respond. Is anyone else out there? God damn it.
Look, we got one.
He's wearing a resistance uniform.
Who did you kill to get that, you filthy machine?
No, don't! Wait, he's human!
Sorry about that, Sergeant. The infiltrators took some of our key positions, so we're extra cautious. If we'd known that you were joining us in the North Division, that would have never happened.
You know who I am.
We all do, Sergeant Rivers. John Connor told us about you. He said you'd come and bring those coordinates.
How did he know I'd have them?
That you'll have to ask him yourself. He's waiting for you upstairs.
That's him. The one Connor's been talking about. Sergeant.
Commander.
Sergeant Rivers, I've been expecting you. I took the liberty of collecting the Central Corps' coordinates you brought us. I hope you don't mind.
Not at all. Are we preparing to attack the Corps?
I've sent a unit to do that. We're getting ready to strike the time displacement equipment. Very soon, SkyNet will realize that they're losing this war, so they'll try to send infiltrators back in time to prevent that from happening.
Do we stand a chance?
Thanks to the security codes that Mac provided, we've been able to seize control of an HK tank for the first time. It should give us the advantage against Skynet's defense grid. We'll smash it once and for all. I understand that all this might be confusing to you, so if you have any questions, now's the time to ask them.
Why am I targeted for termination?
You're the one who discovered the true location of the Central Core. You're the messenger of the intel that could lead to Skynet's downfall.
Who is the stranger?
In one alternative future, we reached the time displacement equipment and sent our soldiers back in time. Like always, the mission was to assure the safety of the people Skynet marked for termination. One of whom was you. Knowing the importance of your mission, many volunteered to go back, so I took it upon myself to choose a protector from among them. And the one I chose was you. You are the one you call Stranger.
No, I don't.
Very well. I'm sure you'll figure out the rest when the time comes. But right now, I want you to get ready. Tonight, soldier, we stop Skynet.
The 124 are on their way to the Central Core.
Then we better get ready.
Take whatever you need, Sergeant.
Thank you.
Sergeant Rivers, it's time. I want you to take a team of my soldiers and fight your way to Skynet's defense grid. We have to destroy those turrets to get to the TDE, but don't worry. We'll provide the support. It's in your hands now, Rivers. Follow me.
Commander?
Commander?
drones!
There's more of them!
Commander, the first sector is secured.
All right, Rivers. Continue the offensive. Preparing to send in the tank.
Watch out!
Zero in on that T-47! Turrets. We'll be right back.
defense grid is active. We can't go through. No way, no how.
HK tank is on its way. Hold your position.
Aerial! Sir, we need backup!
Hang in there!
This is it! That's the lab they keep the time displacement thing!
Spread out!
Commander, what's going on?
The 124 destroyed the central core and stopped SKYNET.
So is the war over?
For some of us, yes. But just before we destroyed the core, SKYNET managed to send three Terminators back in time. The only thing in our power now is to send the Protectors to meet them.
Protectors?
The ones that will assure the safety of the people marked for termination. The first Protector has to be Sergeant Kyle Reese. He'll go after the T-800 that's targeting my mother as we speak. By killing her, SKYNET will try to erase me from ever existing. The second one will seek to destroy the T-1000.
T-1000?
A Terminator made of mimetic polyalloy, sent back to kill me as a child. A single prototype created by Skynet. It's too powerful for a single human being. That's why we'll have to send a Terminator of our own. Do you have that CPU that Mac reprogrammed?
No, I don't.
You don't? Then we've got a problem. I don't believe any of our soldiers are capable of stopping the T-1000. We'll have to find another way, and we have to do it soon. Then, there's the matter of the infiltrator that was sent after you. The war can end for you right now, but the question is, are you willing to sacrifice your future to protect your past? By being here, you've already proven that this is not beyond your capabilities. But I'll leave the decision up to you.
Will I be able to fix my past mistakes?
I always believe that the future's not set. There's no fate but what we make for ourselves. You do have the power to change it and protect the ones you care about. So, what will it be then?
I'll do it. I'll go back.
I knew you would.
Let's hope I won't get killed this time.
Let us begin then.
John Connor prepared the time displacement equipment to send protectors back in time. He knew that the final battle would not be fought here, but in the past. A resistance soldier named Kyle Reese was the first man to go back to 1984. His objective was to protect Sarah Connor, John's mother. There was no way a human could stand up against the more advanced T-1000. But without Dr. Mack to reprogram an infiltrator CPU, Connor would be forced to find another way to get a machine on our side. I couldn't have someone risk their life to protect me. That's why I decided to go myself. It gave me a chance to right the wrongs of my actions. After 30 years, this war against the machines is finally over. But not all of us live to see the end of it. We never found Baron's body in the shelter. She never stopped fighting. And if she's still alive, I doubt she ever will. She was the leader we needed in wartime. But I'm not sure if she'll find a place during this time of peace. Erin died in that shelter. She believed that her work was helping win the war, and she was right. I hope now she can finally rest. Ryan stayed in the shelter and died. He was a good man, with a good heart. Jennifer and Patrick died at the hands of Terminators in the shelter. I wish there was something I could have done to make them leave. I executed Mac. Baron was convinced that he was a threat to our cause. As a soldier, I've been taught to obey orders. But this time, I wasn't sure if it was the right decision. And as for me, it was time to start over.
Listen to me if you want to live.